Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Auto Tutorials. This is Super Sam once again, and in this very episode, I'm going to show you how you can use multiple shape keys for your correctives in Blender. So let's get started. So in the last video, I showed you guys how you can use a single shape key to do correctives on the blink of this particular character, and that works fine, but for a little problem at the top of the first half of the lid closing, we have an unwanted deformation. So because of that, I had to create two different shape keys in order to make sure that my lid close is very smooth, and that is what I'm going to show you in this video. So let's get to it. And before I show you this, I want to show you what I have here, the setup I have here. I already have my keyframes for the close. I have one at the default position, and then I have the second one for the mid position. Then I have the third for the final lid close. And as you can see here, it's not looking good at all, okay? This is why you need a corrective for it. So I'm going to do the first corrective for the midpoint, which is Y at -4 centimeters. And then I'm going to do a second corrective for the total close-up of the lid, which the Y location will be at -7 centimeters. Also, before recording this video, I'd gone ahead to create the keys for this lid, so we don't waste our time trying to edit it. I showed you guys how to do that in the last episode. So if you've not seen the episode, the link will be dropped in the description below. So do well to check it out. Okay, there's a lot of information in that video, also. Now for the key one, I'm gonna push this from 0 to 1 for you to see what it's gonna look like. And it makes no sense here because key one is actually meant for the midpoint of the eye control. So let me go back to the previous keyframe where I have my eye control at the midpoint, and you can see it looks very nice, okay? So without the shape key and with the shape key, this is what it looks like. Now, the second one is the final eyelid close, which is key two. Currently, it is not activated because the key value is at 0. Now, if I want to activate this, I'm gonna put it to the maximum of 1. So when I slide this to 1, you can see I have a smooth close. So now it works this way, take it to 0 and bring it back to 1. But now, of course, you know, you can't easily control this by coming to the shape keys here and changing your value, which means you need a driver to help you do all the work. So you just attach the driver to the particular control for the lid. So whenever you move the lid, the driver responds. And that's what we're going to do now. So let's go back to the K1, and I'm going to go to the midpoint of the lid close. So right click on the value one and come to add driver. So when you have this, you can then change the expression to var, which is a short form for variable. And then I'm going back to the object here, click on the object and search for the rig. Now it depends on your naming convention. For me, my amateur is named rig. That's why I'm searching for rig. So search for the name your amateur has in that particular scene. Now for bone, I'm going to click on the bone here and look for lead dot TL002. No, I selected something wrong. So lead dot, I'm going to scroll down to lead dot TL002. Lead dot TL002. So here is it. Click on that and change the location to Y location. Y location, and then change the space to local space. And now I have the value of -0.040. This value is very important because we're going to work with that. Update dependencies, then go to the driver editor. So we are in the driver editor now. I like to use the A key to select all the keyframes, and then the period key to zoom into the keyframes. It's time for me to change this keyframe. So I'm going to select the first one and go to F curve. In my F curve here, I have the ability to change the interpolation for this curve here. So I'm going to change it to linear. I have the linear interpolation there. And I want the shape key named as key one to start from zero. So this value of zero, I want my shape key to be at the minimum, which is zero. So the keyframe would be zero. This is fine. Now for the second key, I want my shape key for key one to end, to get to its maximum on the second key. And here, the value here is one, but the key frame for key one should also be minus 0.040, which is the value I got after I created the driver and I linked it to the eye control. Okay, you see why the value is very important. So I have this key working. I'm going to turn this off so we see the effect. Now, when I scrub backwards, you can see, okay, you can see, yeah, so I'm having a better feedback compared to what we had in the last video when we tried using just one shape key. So it's time to fix the second one. You can see from frame 6 to frame 11, I have horrible deformation because the character's eye is penetrating the eyeball. So we're going to work with that. So check the key 2 and then go back to the final keyframed location for the eye control. And this time around, I'm going to carry out the same operation, right click and add the driver. So now I have the driver. I'm going to pull this bar here so we can all see it clearly. I have to change the expression also by deleting the plus 1.0. Then I'll go to the object, search for rig, and go to the bone, search for lead.tl002. So I have that lead.tl002. I'm going to change the location to Y. Y location, and the space to local space. And now I have the value of minus 0.070. So this value would also be helpful. And then I'm going to go to the shape editor. So I have the driver editor currently opened, and I'm going to lock for key one because I'm done with key one and I don't want to mistakenly select the curves on key one. So now I have key two unlocked. I'll punch on my A key to select all the keyframes and the period key to zoom into the keyframes. So selecting the first keyframe now, and I'm going to go to F curve. Now for the first keyframe, change the interpolation to linear like we did in the previous one. And this time around, I want key two to start from, the position where key one ended. And key one ended at minus 0.040. So I'm going to use that value as the starting value for key two. So that is a trick. So here you have the starting value here as zero, but for the keyframe value, I'm going to change it to minus 0.040. Okay. And for the second keyframe on the shape named key two, I'm going to change the interpolation also to linear. And the value of one shows that this will be the point for the maximum value for that particular key. So I'm going to change that to minus 0.070. Okay. So now everything had been planned the right way. So when you scrub, you can see the feedback that you have the eyes blinking. So you can go as detailed as you want to in terms of sculpting your mesh in order to get the correct deformation you want. But this is how you use multiple shape key. I can have as much as 10 and above if I want to. But make sure you define where you want each of these keyframes, each of the shape keys to start and end by using the value that you get from the editor, the driver editor. So this value here, okay. So I'm going to do this for the left-hand side alone. I'm not going to touch the right-hand side. And of course, I'm sure you know how to mirror the shape key to the right hand side and then fix everything. But if you don't know how to do so, like I said, check the previous video that was done before this. The link will be dropped in the description below. Do well to check that. You're going to see how you can easily mirror from the left hand side of the character to the right hand side of the character, and that way you get the deformation you want from both eyes of this character. So guys, this is where I'm going to call it a wrap. I hope you've learned one or two things from this video. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to our channel if you've not done so, and until next time, keep your creativity blending.